Hello, everybody. Welcome to the FTOG server. Avant 3, I've got Thorgal and
Hey.
Brock the Duck Farmer here, along
Hello.
with myself, Toddy the Body. How's it going,
howdy.
Everybody?
All howdy, right. Howdy, howdy.
So, what we've got going on today, let me flip around. In my last episode, I was talking about how I really hated making hay bales. You got to place them down. You got to wait for them to dry. There's got to be a way to automate it. I was talking it over with these guys, and we started coming up with some ideas, and then we started arguing about our ideas. You know, who's got the best ones? No, this mod is better than that mod, or that mod is better
Clearly
than this
me?
Mod.
I mean, come on.
No.
Right, and I know that I'm the best. these guys, they think that they're the best. So we're going to have a friendly little competition. Excuse me.
A friendly Thor. Little... friendly. Friendly, yes.
Right, friendly. Competition here where we are going to each make our own hay bale automation, and I think you, the viewers, are going to grade us. You're going to have to give us the results on each of our videos, so you're going to have to check out each one. Where did you go? There you are. You're going to have to check out each one of us and our designs, because we'll do an overall at the end, but to see how each one works, you're just going to have to get the first person view of each of us. Yep, how many times can I say each of us?
Do it one more time.
Right, each of us.
I would have a question, though. Do you like... You hate making hay bales more than you hate making sticks, or less?
Oh, that's pretty close.
Because you have a stick... FOMA.
Yes,
is that
right.
A thing?
That, and I think it's a combination of, I don't think that I can have enough sticks. If you guys or anybody else would love to give me sticks or trade for sticks, I will take them.
Ooh. Oh, hey, I have a plan. I have a cunning plan.
And hay bales now, too.
So, Grok, tell us about this place here. You made this little thingamajiggy.
Yep, I went ahead and set this place up, and it's a place.
Thanks. So... See you guys next time.
Yep, see ya. So, it is... got the FTOG colors, so, you know, hey, everything FTOG, and it's a chunk for each. Well, it's a 16 by 16 for everybody. We have alloy smelters and sag mills for each, and they're powered. There's also, don't stand in the shield. There's also a shield here that will black out each quadrant so people can build in complete anonymity and security, and knowing that they won't be cheating by stealing my really good ideas.
Say that word again.
Security? Anonymity.
Anonymity? Oh.
Yeah, there's no way I can say that. I'm very
it
proud of you.
Rolls right off. It sounds good.
So that's this here. We've got clear glass up on the top, and I love it because you just can't see it. At all, unless
that's
you're
clear.
Up there. Yeah, it's clear. And we have a thing here in the front, a dropper with one of each of the blocks. And that way we know where we're going to be, because it's completely random. And he's a mower. Oh, yeah, seeds for me. So, Toddy, it's your shindig. Go ahead and push the button and see where you're going to be building.
Right on. Okay.
Purple.
Oop. Emerald. All right, Thor. You're next.
Oh, you knew it. Come on. I mean, I got the redstone over my head. It's got to be.
I got the gold already.
I'm putting this back in there.
Yeah, we'll put it back in.
Me too.
So I need to set up a area for getting access to my stuff, because you've got remote access and I don't.
Yeah, I can't think of anything that I have to pre-set up. But I think in the rules, we're allowed to go back to our base.
Yeah, well, I mean, this is for fun. This is supposed to... I listened to you, but I don't remember. Did you explain that this is not supposed to be, you know, super efficient and everything? More like, you know, fun and creative?
I didn't get to it. I want to list off some of the...
Have at it.
Some of the grading categories that I've come up with. Not official, so... You know, if we ever want to change them in the future or something, just some ideas, like what you all can think of when you're trying to grade our videos. I'm trying to actually go through chat to find them. Okay, I came up with 4, and then we'll sort of 5 categories. The first one is aesthetics. So, you know, if somebody is more of a builder than technical, then they can make it look good and earn some points that way. We've got Fun Factor, and that's sort of the thing, like, it's a sort of a machine where you just want to sit there and just watch it. You don't even need the stuff that it makes. You just want to watch it because it's fun to watch. So like one of those satisfying videos on YouTube. Efficiency, and then that would be like maybe how fast it works or how much it makes. You know, just, you know, efficiency, it speaks for itself. Number four, the amount of automation. So you can have it to where it feeds, you know, if it's 100% automation, or you can have it to where you have to feed it grass, or you have to feed it bone meal, or you have to power it, or maybe it powers itself, or, you know, whatever. And then overall, just a plain old overall, you know, who do you think was the best one? And then if you do leave a vote down in our descriptions or comments, then go ahead and leave like a reason why, so that we know, instead of just saying, oh, you're the best no matter what, because you have a black shirt and I like black shirts.
I think I'm winning the sparkly category. My quadrant here, yes, is the far sparklier than anybody else's.
So I just can't right stop there. Being silly. All right, should we go?
Yeah, I think we should. Let's
all right,
more switches. And if
yeah, I can still see the sparklies
right
through the wall. Yeah. Oh, he's breaking.
Well, if you flip, I am. But if you flip the switches too, then it won't go down until all three of the switches have been flipped.
Oh, so you can't cheat.
I
got
you.
Right. Good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And absolutely no talking
so
the entire episode.
Get started.
Oh, I see. I already forgot using push to talk. We turned on our push to talk so we can talk to our viewers when we explain something. It's gonna drive me bananas. So I'm just gonna, you know, say one thing about my build here. When it's done, it is completely self-efficient. Yeah. Mm-hmm. No manual feeding of it. Nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Will never run out.
I'm hoping mine will be the same. And it'll look far better because it was sparkly.
Clearly.
I'm going to push the talk, you guys.
All right. So, guys, they can't hear me right now.
The hay to actually work,
gonna
you need lava underneath.
Mute this
and
for
so that's
a
what I'm putting
second
right here.
Grok, you're not push the talkie.
Oh, I thought I was.
Nope.
Oh, okay. I'm so used to talking and pushing to talk that it's hard for me.
All right, guys. So I left the channel for a second. I do want to hang out with them because I enjoy playing with these guys, and I think it's going to be awesome, this project. But my idea behind this, again, it's all about making hay bales, right? And I wanted to make sure that was kind of my goal for this project. You know, besides making it a little overcomplicated and stuff, I got all this prepared. You guys see there's a lot of stuff. And I only have very little botania. And this thing right here, what is it called again? The conjuration catalyst. I don't even have an Alfheim portal. So let's see here, I think. Yeah. I actually went over to Grok Space and used his Alfheim portal to make the parts for this cataclyst here, because when you drop a piece of grass into this, it makes two grass. Okay, so right now what I'm gonna set up here first, getting a little bit all over the place here, we didn't have much time, we didn't want to, you know, prepare everything too much, so we all played around with a few ideas and then I just crafted away. This is gonna be yes. And I wanted to figure out an easy way that fits in here. You know, I didn't want to make a tree farm and so on. To make mana. So I decided I'm gonna go with this lava factory from. Oh, whoa, that's one too low. With the lava factory from actually additions, and then we can make endless grass, and then we're gonna set up a way to send the grass to a placing mechanism, because the way. Ooh, I don't have any lava with me. I'm gonna have to go back to get some. In order to make the thatch, let me just show you guys real quick on how it actually works, because you guys might, why don't you just make wheat? It doesn't work in this pack. To make hay bales, you need 4 of these hay blocks, and they are made with 4 small hay piles, and that you make with 2 loose hay, each one of them. So you need 32? Yeah, 32 of these per hay bale. And you get these by placing grass on stone that is on top of lava. And then that dries it out, and then we need to harvest that. Sorry about that. I don't know why I dug down so far, but I need this to be... This is full, right? Okay, it's filling. So now this should make me lava, and I'm going to need to get these two out of here. And we are going to place... Oh, I hope I have one of those on me. If not, then I'll have to go back for that as well. Don't think I have a wand of the forest. Okay, now I need to go back home for a second, but I don't think I can look in. Oh, awesome. Okay, I cannot look in. I didn't want to, you know, feel like I'm cheating here, so we're going to go back. Arr! No! How do I get home? This? I clicked on the wrong eye. Here we are. And we wanted to record all this in one take here, and I can't believe I forgot my wand forest. Where would I have that? I know I made one. In here? Hey. I did set up a little bit of a Botania area here a little while ago to automate living rock and living... What did I do with my wand of the forest? Is it here? Awesome. So I need that. And what was the other thing? Yes, I needed to bring lava. I need some of that. And then I should have everything. I forgot those. All right. So now let's go back over there. So I'm going to use the Therma Lilies. I was in the redstone area. Yes, to make mana, because, well, all I need to send is power to this. Yep. There's already some lava right there. Let me get grass, and we'll put those here and there. Okay, so like I said, it's going to make lava, mana. Mana, we duplicate the grass. The grass goes, gets planted, then it's going to get broken. It's going to be sent to get assembled, and then stored. So that is the idea behind it, and it's going to be endless. As long as I keep sending power here, so that means this needs to stay chunk loaded. Then it should not have any problems, you know, running endless. And that is all the time I want to spend with you guys alone. So I'm going to pop over into the other channel here. There we go. We're getting some mana. And this was just the best way I could figure out how to make endless mana without having other things. So let me pop over to the other guys again. All right, guys, I'm back.
Hey, what's up?
Sorry, I just wanted to focus for a minute to explain what my thought process was behind it, and now I'm here. All right. How are you guys doing? You guys done yet?
Almost.
You know, I believe it.
All right, I've got the villagers hard at work. We've got the puppies are all doing their things.
So I had an idea what I might do here. Even if we don't walk through our... We're probably going to explain our setups when we're done, right?
Yeah.
Otherwise, if I forget steps or something, I think I'm going to just use text on the screen, like why I placed what I just placed, for example, what is the point of it, and so on. That might not be bad.
I'm sitting here talking to you guys without my push the talk button down.
Don't you hate that?
Yeah, I'm having a whole conversation and people are just ignoring me.
Yes, I know that feeling.
All right, I disabled mine. So if I need to just talk to the peeps, I'm just going to go to the other channel or mute it or something. I just know, when I'm just playing with friends and so on, then it's a totally different story. But here we're gonna have to focus and.
Yes.
I'm keeping my own. I'm more talking my way through it. Just because I don't have a design for a lot of this stuff.
I don't believe a word. I think you set this up 15 times already. Perfected it, and it's probably gonna make the server lag because you got so much stuff going on.
Well, I've been real good this server.
Yep, the thing I did is I figured out what it was that could get the grass to be placed and then the hay picked up. And once I figured that out, then I mentally mapped out everything else. And I sure hope this is a trippy look here.
I just equipped some conduits and all the floor and the walls went away.
Yes, because the half slabs is a much better idea.
Okay, the priority here, guys, I'm pretty sure you guys can figure out what that is for, because we are going to pump out the grass from here, and I want to make sure this stays full. That's why I put 9 stacks in here, okay? Because otherwise, if I set this in motion, this whole thing is going to fill first before the grass goes to where we're going to turn it into the precious hay. Whoever came up with the idea that from the Terraquis people that this was a good idea to make hay this complicated? Huh?
Well, hay is so vastly important. Everybody should be doing hay all the time.
Clearly.
They're like, hey, we need to change that.
Yeah.
Was that...
No, never again. I'm trying to figure out...
I ran out of sticks, I'll have you know, Toddy.
Do you ever notice that they disappear from the mob farm?
Are you really taking the sticks from over there?
I am sure taking them.
Hey, do either of you guys need lava? I brought a tank with 16 buckets.
I was just going to make if I need more.
I put the tank outside between redstone and gold. Feel free to use some. I just need... What happened? Oh, you gotta shift-click it. I guess I could have used the lava from over there, but... That's alright. Everybody's really focused. Can you guys hear all the brain cells?
I know I'm like listening to you and then like trying to do my own at the same time. I totally stopped talking since we started talking together again.
Well, we have never done a build off like this before, so
yeah,
it's completely new to us. But I was really excited about this. I can't wait to see. I think it's really exciting to see, you know, what are other people coming up with. I think it's really cool.
Right.
Why are you going to be evil? Quiet.
That's going to be quiet. Yeah, you shouldn't hear that at all. No, sorry.
Oh, he's trying us right now.
Yeah.
I'm succeeding.
I keep opening the wrong bags, which is probably driving the peeps nuts.
I cannot figure out how to use this thing block from this mod. The item filter from RF Tools.
Item filter from RF Tools. Down. You only need to get the first one in place, guys. You're going to see. And then after that, I noticed that when you place these... Pointing down? No. Down. Can I go down here? Me? No. Like. I don't know how to do this. I might have to pick up the lava again.
Let's do Use that. Your hands.
Use your hands. I don't have some fancy beacons like you that protect me from everything.
That's what makes me so nice and cute, and people like me that way.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Mrs. Duck Farmer keeps telling you that.
Yes.
You guys didn't see that. I almost burned myself in lava.
I saw it.
No, you didn't. Cheater. Don't be cheating. Bam. Bam. So, by the way, this was the only way. I think we spoke about this earlier. And those two guys might have lied to me, but I don't think so. Mechanical user was the only way I could figure out how to place... I am such an idiot.
I went through so many different methods, and yeah, mechanical user pointing down was the only way I could get it to work.
I hate myself so much.
You shouldn't feel bad. We hate you so much right now too.
Oh my god.
Always and forever. But I love technology.
What? You lost me.
I caught that movie reference.
Fill me in.
It's a movie called Napoleon Dynamite. Have you seen it?
Oh, yeah.
When Kip is singing his song when he's getting married. Oh, he's in forever. But I love technology. I don't know. I don't know a song. I love you, but not more than technology. No, wait. I love you more than technology. I don't know. I'm not the singer. Kip
is. I just spent like 3 minutes trying to place these mechanical users, and then I placed them at the wrong height. Oh, my God. Bam, bam. I really can't. I'm wondering why I hear so much. I'm guessing that one of them, or at least one of them, is actually using bone meal. And we hear the shearing the whole time. From over there.
I don't hear any shearing.
It may be a manual shearing. And it just looks like it's automated right now.
Oh. Watch. Grok's over there, he's like, yeah, I'm doing all this fancy stuff, and he's just gonna make, like, 50 stacks of hay bales by hand, and so Toddy never needs any, ever again.
Yeah, the automation will be putting it in a chest.
Yep.
And it could work that way, yeah.
Okay, I'm starting to get in the groove. He messed me up this part, so they come over here to there, please. And then we need timer. And I found out 3,000 is, what did we say, 2.5 minutes, right?
What?
Something like that, yeah.
3,000 ticks is 2.5 minutes.
Yeah.
I found them to be able to be harvested up as quick as 2,400. But a lot of times when you do it, then you get some crappy grass. Oh.
Yeah, I hate crappy grass. It's no good.
I just had the problem that I tried to place a conduit on the floor, but the floor is made of...
It's conduit covers, or
I know,
facades.
So it went kind of in there. But it's okay. He totally did that on purpose to manipulate...
I was going
to
say, it was totally on purpose, because you were going to get the redstone one, and that way you'd be messed up.
So keep that in mind, guys, that when you vote for me, you know, that I had the hardest surface, the most difficult surface.
Wah.
What did I need power for? Yes, I remember now. Okay, good. So, which do we have in there? Okay, a little bit. That's definitely could use two more of these, but it's okay. Timed. Gonna run this stuff. Oh no, yeah, these are to pull out of the these guys right there. Then it's gonna go down and then up here. F the input.
You should run it on the other side. It'll work better for you.
Okay, I'll get right on that.
Yep, you do that.
Toddy hasn't said a word. Toddy is
He's in
completely
concentration
gone.
mode. I am.
This is serious business, man.
There is a lot on the line here.
Reputation. So what, hey, we had some ideas earlier, but did we ever come up with what we're actually gonna do now for the winner?
I like the bragging rights.
Are we
Yeah.
gonna do the episode thing? Whatever next episode? That
Yeah,
one?
I like that. I like that works. I think that
All
works out
right, go
nicely.
ahead and explain to the peeps what that means.
We were saying that whoever wins obviously needs to have the rest go around and acknowledge the entire next video, how excellent of a builder they are.
I would love that. Yeah, that would sound good with my name after that.
Totally. Okay. I am so, you know, it's kind of funny because usually you have so much time preparing something and thinking it over and that right there.
Yeah, I'm considering whether or not to like maybe cut stuff or just leave it all in and everybody's gonna have to see an hour-long episode.
I think
I'm
I'm gonna decide that when I actually edit. But I don't think we'll have a lot of downtime, right? When you record
I'm
this.
yeah, I'm trying to build as fast as I can here.
Same.
See, this is priority 0. This up there was 10, so it will keep this one full and only the excess gets put over here and then goes into there. There, oop. That goes into here, and for that I also had an idea. That is, I have very first time I have never used the item conduit speed downgrade before. But I noticed today that when you use Ender IO conduits and you want to equally distribute something that you have very slow incoming, it doesn't spread it equally because when there's four or more, it will pull out four at the minimum speed without upgrades. And when you use the downgrade, it will put out one at a time. So it will, once I change this here to round robin, it will put one, 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 and then start over. Otherwise, like I put in, let's say 40. Yeah, you might get 12, 12, 8, 8. I'm 30. 40? 12, 12, 8, 40. Don't ever do math on camera.
Oh, math on camera is hilarious when other people
Yeah.
are doing
And then when you watch the video and you edit and you're like, really? That took me that long?
Yeah.
Okay, so grass pops on here, goes over there, goes into here. Like we said, we want to use as many different mods as possible. So this is considered a mod, these two. That's vanilla.
The vanilla mod, my favorite.
Yes,
I
the
would say
vanilla
that's just
mod.
one. If it's if it's Minecraft vanilla, that's just one mod, right?
Yeah, what?
Yeah.
You can't
Right?
say, well, this is a vanilla method, and that's a vanilla method, and that's a vanilla method, and that's a
Well,
vanilla
that's just
method.
one. What are you talking about? What is happening? Okay, and then here, come around to here. Yes, and now here, let's keep this off for a second. Got a little something to build. Which I am fully aware of, guys, that I only need one of these. Because they handle three, but I thought it's gonna look cooler. When we have multiples of these. These are the best machines in the game. You guys wish you knew what I was talking about.
Yes.
It would be nice, yes.
You're talking about pistons.
No, I'm talking about words. Immersive engineering assemblers. I love those things. Okay, and then I gotta remember how to do this. I don't have my book with me, so I need to wing this right now. Like that? God, I hope I got this right. This way? Yes! Oh! Whoa. Why isn't this one... What?
Oh, that's coming along very nicely there.
Where did it go? How does one of them not form? That makes no sense. Oh, okay. I think it was because I was clicking on the skinny side of the conveyor instead of on the top. But anyway, so we got these, and then between these, set up those, and then come out somewhere. Ah. All right, we're getting there.
What's the time count so far?
I'm not keeping track at all.
We are... I'm going to say close to 30 minutes, 25-ish. I am actually... My recording shows 36 minutes, but we did do quite a bit of babbling.
Yeah, we did that, so...
But I started just before we said, all right, Toddy, finally do the intro, man. Stop messing around, trying to influence us.
I was trying to get your idea.
Yeah, he totally did. Your idea.
I'm totally going to use that vanilla mod now.
The vanilla mod, I love it.
Yes, I'm going to use that too.
So don't know if I need this, but I just want to make sure this stuff doesn't fall over place. And okay, let's do it this way. Really? You gotta be kidding me. Can't wait to see What? Oh, it's down in here. Oh, I thought I lost that one cover. That would have been a bummer. Precious covers. So both of you are not going to talk anymore, seriously?
Sorry.
It's thoughts here. Yeah, I'm sitting here trying so hard to think, and I'm having a hard time.
Does it hurt?
It's painful.
All right, so this is still there. This set always. This is priority 0, and this is still... And it, you can just put it at 1, it doesn't really matter. But I always like to make a clear distinction. And does this not do anything anymore? Oh, well, duh. You guys didn't see that. This.
Hallelujah. Got something to work.
I know
now you're all toast.
Now we're in trouble.
You finally figured out that you can use shears on grass?
Is that what it is? Darn. Let me put the wrench away.
Ah, this is set to pulse. Yes. All right. So now we actually going to have to do... let me double check all this. This is be set to insert. This extract. Extract. And this right here should work already. So we can just test this here. Place this one down. It should break it here after 2.5 minutes eventually. Let me clean up my bags a bit. I think I need any more of those. Okay. Now, how he actually gets the hay bales out of this storage system that I'm putting here, that is his problem.
Toddy, Thor's using a storage method.
Of course,
what am I using? Yes.
I'm going to have to put my millions of hay blocks somewhere that he's going to produce over the next millennia with this awesome way that I'm doing over here, the bestest ever.
I'm planning on letting this run for at least 20, 60 years.
I think they are 6 high. I don't know. Yes, they are. Awesome. Cool.
This is a trick of yours, Thor, to talk and, like, get us, like, not thinking about what we're doing.
He is so sneaky that way.
Yeah.
How dare I talk during a YouTube video? How dare I?
It out.
Guys, they got me.
Oh, that works.
Hey, we you have to get up real early in the morning to pull the wool over our eyes. Something like that.
Up here, we're going to use this beautiful thingy because I learned, even though it shows a crate up here, right? It doesn't accept anything.
Sorry, I started talking to other people.
You are forgiven, my friend.
Thank you.
How do you connect these? There a way to make this go up there? Oh! Ah, it broke it. You guys saw it? Broke something. Where'd it go? What? Well, Did it, what? Where'd it go?
I took it. Sorry. It's mine now.
I think that it broke it, but it didn't get it. Okay. Let's do a test over here. Just to make sure this actually works. Oh. Ah. It's going to break it before the timer is up, but that's fine. Put one. Oh, yeah. And I brought two stacks of sticks with me. Two upper left slot only. And I want to make sure that I don't have more than one stack of brass waiting in each one of these. So the thing cannot place, you know, sticks. You can't place sticks in the world. So that's why I went with those. In case you guys are wondering, because you won't be able to see it later on your videos, because you cannot right-click the mechanical user. Actually, I thought there was a way to allow you... There's some command I saw in somebody else's video.
Yeah, there is a command that you can issue that will grant somebody else access to your extra utility stuff.
Maybe we should cut at the end, figure that out, so we can look... I don't know if you guys are using stuff, too, that runs on the GP network. But that way you can look into these machines.
I'm using that vanilla mod.
All of it. Nothing else.
Because I'm just that hardcore.
This isn't... Okay. We have one more thing to set up. Your guys' all-time favorite. So I brought a programmer, processor, and a note. And this is... What way am I facing here? Why am I so small? You guys notice that on Journey Map, when you zoom in, the icons don't get bigger anymore?
I did notice that.
Like, I think I'm facing north. Let's just do F3. Facing north. Okay. All right, so in the processor, we're going to do the core and one card. Here, we're going to do a little bit of programming. Very simple, guys. Don't run away. And I'm going to say every 3 seconds, we are going to check count externally. And because it's right next to that chest, it's going to be the processor. It's going to be north. And we are checking for grass. That is it. And then we need to have a greater than. Variable one. The last integer, check if it's bigger than zero. If yes, so we're gonna have to go no, we're gonna go down, and yes, right. If yes, stop the program. If no, this is something new. Test it. Get out. Like I said, because I put it manually, you guys see. Some of them are not fully grown. And if the server tick will catch up, they will come in here. But there is one in here, which is cool. So these right there, we can just trash later. So the first recipe is this. This right there. Small hay piles. Once it has four, it's going to go over there. Anyway, let's go back here. So I'm going to set up this node first. Channel we're going to call T-Hay. The node one. Doesn't matter.
Well, while you're doing that, could you give a count as to how many hay bales you have completed now?
Zero.
Toddy?
Zero. I am
Brock?
About... Yeah, go ahead.
Two?
Automatically?
Well, they... I had to make one so I could process. The other one got made automatically.
Okay.
Again, we not that important that you make a lot.
Oh, sure it is.
No, it's not. Totally useless.
I win mine is bigger, you know, award.
Uh-huh.
And sparklier.
So I couldn't figure out if you can pulse So right here, I'm setting the redstone over there on that node north to 15, and then right after the Z. So that is like a pulse, okay? So now we're gonna put these in here. Set this to always active. You guys are gonna see, gonna put one at a time. You see that? Yep. Three, and that's probably two, three here in a second. So once these are full, but of course now this is gonna be empty. So the node is there. So now we can save this program, call it Jorge. Put it into the processor. And we still need to, ooh, this needs power. But first we're gonna do the thing. I can never remember that. Net setup VA. Found the node. That is what I brought these for. So see? Every 3 seconds, if there is no more grass here, it will drop a grass in. And it's fast enough, if the server does catch up, that it actually duplicates just before this vacuum chest. You guys are always going to see two. You see that? I tested that earlier. It never pulls in the one that drops down because it's after this. It will always hit the mana pool before it goes into the vacuum chest. So that means, and also, of course, up here, you see, it's going to go to 63, and then it's going to fill up that one because it has priority 10, and the other one goes over there. So, endless grass or a little bit of power. And these right here I brought. We're going to have to talk to the weather station owner. Or right here. So these guys are getting some RF.
60% of the time, it works every time.
Oh, I'm so happy about that weather station. So now it's all about waiting. So now it's going to make the first pile, which is going to go in here. Let's see it pop out. There it is. Now we can set up this recipe. And then these right there are going to go to over here. And once I have four, I can make the recipe to make the actual hay bale. And that's going to go into this. That's it. I'm done. Are you guys done?
Negative.
I automatically get plus points for that.
I am you're first. Functional. I just want it to be better than yours.
Okay, we did say because I'm putting down my wrench, I think I'm going to have to come back one time to set up a recipe.
Okay, it's weird. Hold on. Oh, sorry. Again, talking to my own people and hitting
no problem. But we did say once you're done, you know, you say you're done, it's okay to look around and what the other people are doing, right?
Yes, you can look around.
Okay. Like I said, I have to set up one more recipe, but I just got to wait for grass to dry. It's paint drying. You know what I mean. Pretty cool. I like it. I think it turns out well. Let's go. Who's the golden boy here? Whoa.
That is me.
Whoa. Yeah, he's definitely... Oh, look at this guy. Are you kidding me? He's got... I don't know if I want to name it.
Yeah, don't give it away.
Thing and one of those others, that vanilla mod.
Why do I see this outline here? Why do you... Oh, get out of here. Seriously? Overkill?
I'm making it look good.
All right, I can't wait to see what this does in the end. I'm going over to the green guy.
Where's my visitor? Are you hiding?
I'm right here behind you.
Oh, there you are.
I'm walking in. I'm gonna be super nosy.
Yep. I haven't figured out this part over here yet. Okay, so I don't have bone meal automated. That is the only thing that I need.
Hey guys, we're done now. How awesome was this? It was a lot of fun, right? He just goes right into it.
All right then. cut all the chit chat.
It was amazing.
It's time to explain. Well, I want to get past mine so I can look at these.
Right.
All right. I guess we would have done some cutting there.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm going to keep it in. I think that's fantastic.
You got all that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, here we go for Thor. Okay, guys. So we're back. I had to cut out, or maybe I didn't, to finally get my thoughts down here on paper, because these guys, they finished way ahead of me. I think they cheated. I think they had it under the floor and they just lifted it up or something, because mine took way longer, like, what, half an hour longer? No?
Or two.
15 minutes?
Yeah.
10 minutes?
Or 2 hours?
It took longer. They were just over there.
We've been talking smack to him, though, for a long time, so they right. probably took his concentration.
Throwing snow at each other or grass or whatever. And so I finally got mine done, and since mine looks, I think I'm going to lose on aesthetics for sure compared to, I mean, look at the factory over there.
I have to admit, that's pretty cool looking.
Yeah, if you win, you have to set this up over at my base.
Okay.
All right, agreed.
Which there's no doubt in my mind, but yeah. All right, now let's focus here so we get through these setups here, because I really want to understand every one of them.
Okay, so underneath we've got a mechanical user. Mechanical user will shoot a bone meal up top. Let me put just a tad a bit in there. I'm going to put 16. And then we'll up on top, you can see it starts to plant. And then above it, you've got the winter shears inside there, which don't lose durability. So they're shearing the grass, and then it is being picked up by the range collector. The range collector is from Actually Editions. It picks up items instantaneously, and you can whitelist and blacklist items, and it you can pipe out of it, I guess. I used another Actually Editions block, so it's a little bit more cooperative in understanding what it's meant to do. It's an advanced ESD, which means multiple things. Right now it's energetic solo dancer system dude. Okay. yeah. So you can also whitelist and blacklist stuff inside there, and what direction things are coming in and what direction things are coming out. And it is just going to pick or push everything that gets picked up into this chest here. And there's nothing in the chest because it's all being moved to different places. So let's see. Let's go over here and then we'll come back to it.
One question. That button down here doesn't do anything, right?
It was a testing button.
Okay, yeah. Gotcha.
So okay. It's for decoration. It looks like a nose, you know?
Clearly.
Yeah. Yep, see? No. And then one eye over here. So it's the one-eyed grass maker.
No, don't go any further. No. No. I do like the bioreactor idea, by the way. I think that's really cool.
Yeah, so I get a lot of extra drops. I want the grass for the hay, but then, you know, you get poppies and seeds and all kinds of stuff. And I just ship that right on over here to bioreactor. It's kind of like the thing from Manufacturer Reloaded. What? Mine Factory Reloaded.
Uh-huh.
And I think it's the same name, isn't it? But if you have the more variety you have in here, the more it will make as far as RF6. So like
wasn't
right
the
now.
Mine Factory Reloaded though two machines? One made the biofuel, and then that actually burned, right? I think so.
Right. Yeah. Same principle. It would make more biofuel if you had more variety.
More variety, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it pumps all the extra seeds and everything into here, which gives power to the two machines that need power, the crafter and the builder block. And we'll come back to that. So then the grass gets filtered upwards and over and into these mechanical users. And they're pointing downwards to place the grass onto these stones. So how I harvest the loose hay is that I have these pistons on a monostable circuit. And they'll reach up, and they're sticky pistons. They'll reach up, and they'll grab the stones and pull them down, which breaks the grass, which gets picked up by the range collector, another one over on this side. And
that's a very smart way to make a mono circuit.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
Yep. I have a sequencer so that it will pulse one time to move the blocks away and then pulse again to put them back into place. And what I found out yesterday is that you don't need a source block to make these loose, to make the loose hay. So flowing lava works also. Once you have the loose hay picked up inside the ranch collector, it just moves on over to the crafter. And this stuff is pretty basic. It gets crafted the different steps until it makes a hay bale, which gets moved over to this chest. And underneath the chest is a builder block. And I have it set so that when it gets a hay bale, it will just place it into the world over here. And then when you're ready, you can come by and get a piece of hay and then go and breed some horses with it.
So now you got all of these, all seven of these hay bales with this little factory you built here?
Nope. These I had before just to test the concept. Okay. Because I didn't think you guys want to wait for me to actually make hay.
Right.
All right, well, I guess the only question I have right now, how do you get the power from the bioreact? Oh, I keep looking at these conduits thinking they are item conduits. Of course, yeah. You know, for a bioreactor that makes 4 RF a tick right now, we're going to use conduits that can do 20,000.
Yes, that's the only
overkill
way to do
much.
It.
Yes, I don't think I have a recipe for the others.
He does not get extra points for this, guys. Okay? No.
Overkill. So, yeah, I think afterwards you'll just need to make sure you get a count of all the different mods you made and a listing, because I think that would be good to see.
Sure.
No problem. He's got RF Tools, Vanilla, Actually Additions, and Ender.io.
Extra Utilities.
Yeah. That's... Yeah, you said RF Tools already? Yeah, that's it.
So let's do it again. RF Tools, Extra Utilities, Ender.io...
Actually additions,
vanilla. Well, that's five.
And oh, reliquary, the shears.
Yep.
Ah, reliquary.
And Terraquis. Okay.
Yep.
Oh, for the hay.
So we're at 7, right?
Yep. All right. So mine.
Right, I'm gonna just break 7 blocks here.
That works.
Real quick, just so we don't need to count again. And don't worry, you get your precious emeralds back.
They can stay here.
All right, 7. Go, Grok.
All right, so mine, I start up here with a soul cage with skeletons, and it will spawn in the skeletons. They die and drop their loot, and it's scattered hither and yon to make the server cry. And then I do have that soundproof block there just so that you guys wouldn't hear skeletons come in. I didn't want you to know that I was spawning skeletons, but that was Toddy's idea, and I shamelessly stole it. So the advanced item collector here is whitelisted to pick up. Nope, no, it's fantastic. No. It picks up bones and grass, because that's the only thing I really care about. Now, the production, well, here, the bones get sent into the crafter. There's a recipe to turn the bones into bone meal. Those get sent into the dispenser, which has a timer on here from Dark Utilities, so that it will click up, and you can plant grass from underneath, and Toddy mentioned that earlier. But I'd seen that done before. And then the reliquary pedestal with the shears of winter on it, as you can see, will just go through and grab the or the grass, but it leaves the stinking flowers, and that's really a pain. So I went ahead and set up another timer here, one that pulses instantly, one that has a little bit of a delay to this dispenser with a water bucket in it, and every so often it'll just flood and get rid of all the flowers. And with more time and or caring, I would get something to filter out the flowers and vend them away or do something cool like make power. So planting, everybody's doing the mechanical users pointed down, and I've got 2 rows of 8. So I've got 16 harvest areas or growing areas, and I'm using the refined storage destructors to go ahead and grab the finished loose hay. And that gets shoved into the chest, which then gets sucked up into the RF Tools crafter, which I could just leave that there. And I made one manually here, so I'm up to 6 now that have been done so far. So I'm thinking mine's a beast as far as efficiency.
Yeah, it's a beast. It's a beast, all right.
I really like the pedestal idea.
It gives me a large area for getting lots of grass.
Yeah.
I also like the skeleton idea. I think it's really cool.
Yeah.
That's really neat.
Yeah, so that's Toddy's idea. He mentioned it yesterday, and I was saying, oh, that's fantastic. But I didn't say that I was going to use it.
Yeah, I was joking because that's like the first thing you make on the two servers so far.
Yes, because everybody needs the resources that the mobs drop, and so I make them. So I said, oh, yes, I'm definitely going to do that.
All right, let's count. So we got Soul Shards, Reborn, Vanilla, that's two.
Extra then utilities.
You got Dark Utilities down there, three. Extra Utilities, four.
RF Tools.
Five. Terraquist, six. Mechanism, Reliquary. We're not counting because that's Mechanism.
That's just my power. No. So Reliquary, did you get that?
All right, let's start over.
You got this. Okay, I will name and you count.
Yep.
So the precious vanilla mod of Minecraft for
okay,
the
faster than that. Vanilla, Soul Shards Reborn.
Extra Utilities, RF Tools. I'm using Reliquary. I'm using Ender IO. I'm using Redstone Paste. Extra Utilities, we talked about. Refined Storage. And
Terraquis.
RF Tools. Terraquis for the hay.
And you also the timer.
Random things. And what was the timer? Timer is Dark Utilities.
So you got 11. Wow. So nice. You got us on that. All right, watch out. 1, 2, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11. So we don't need to count again.
Yep.
All right, now let's go to the aesthetically pleasing build.
I do like it, but see, I didn't build mine beforehand.
I didn't build mine beforehand. I played around with ideas. I did build the multi-block machines to make sure I know how to form them, but... All right, so everything starts for me with mana over here with the Thermal Lilies, and I got the Actri Additions Lava Generator. Underneath that is an RF Tools Power Cell from my main power, just so I can power them, because it takes, I think, 150,000 RF per lava block. And then the way it works over here is when you drop one piece of grass into this Botania mana pool, underneath is the thing I can never remember the name. Conjuration catalyst.
Yeah.
Yes.
That one will split things and get multiples back.
So it makes two, and then right after that, it gets sucked up by the vacuum chest, which makes sure it sends back up. The precision dropper stays full because it has a higher priority, and the lower priority goes to this conveyor belt. So, and then it goes over here into the hopper. I could have just run conduit, but I wanted to have moving parts. Goes into the chest. And then this is kind of a little bit what the magic is with the processor. The program checks if there is any grass in this chest. If there is, nothing happens. If there is no chest, every 6 seconds, it's going to emit the redstone signal on this node to this dropper to drop a piece of grass. I didn't want to do it faster. There's no reason for it. And then, of course, as soon as there is excess grass in this chest, it doesn't do anything anymore. And then here, the first time I used a item conduit speed downgrade, because when you use the round robin, by default, Ender IO pulls four at a time, and I only wanted one, so I always have the same amount in these mechanical users, which place it. And then I'm going with the timer over here from RF Tools, 3200 delay that harvests it and puts it on this conveyor, which goes into the first assembler, which makes the small hay piles. Goes to the second, which makes the hay blocks, and then to the third one to make the actual hay bales. And then it comes out here, goes up there, and goes into Toddy's new silo that we're going to see over in the space very shortly, and making him all the hay bales in the world.
There's two there.
What?
Yep.
Yeah, you two actually made bales. A hay bale.
Yep,
the,
I know.
The one you took from me, and you got one there.
And we got to count again. But I'm pretty sure I had 8, but let's count real quick. So we got, obviously, a little bit of immersive engineering, Ender IO, Botania, Vanilla, Actually Editions, RF Tools, RF Tools Control. Uh-huh. That's 7, Extra Utilities 8, Terraquis is 9.
Yep.
Yep.
All right, 9. Ooh, just barely behind Croc. All right, so we got 7, 9, and 11. And 11. Okay.
Yep.
Well, that's it. Anything else, guys? Again, leave comments down there, guys. I don't know. Do we want to set up like a site where people can actually vote? There's sites like that.
You know, I say just let people comment, and then we can just decide it's me.
No. I mean, item spillage right there. That's unacceptable. Toddy's getting a couple point deductions because he took 2 hours longer.
Oh my gosh. That's being thoughtful, that's all.
Well, I think that's it, huh?
If you guys want to come over to my video and talk trash about the other two designs, that's fine too.
Alright. Well, I had a lot of fun, guys. We gotta do this more often. I think this is a really cool way of figuring out stuff. And then especially seeing how everybody does it so different. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Make sure you check out everybody's perspective and leave your comments. Let us know which design you guys like best. I think they're all three awesome, but which one do you guys like the best? Let us know why. Right. And also leave comments. Like if you have another ideas, like, hey, why didn't you guys try this out or something? That would have been cool to implement, because sometimes we just forget things. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the episode. Say bye, everybody.
Take care.
Stay safe. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.